helmet with the
green. Well, yellow helmet. Yes.
Big C on the side.
And the green pants with the yellow stripe. Warren County has got a different combination tonight. They are wearing the red jerseys with blue numerals, white football pants, and white helmets.
Looks good. Good clean look.
It is.
It's been a good week at practice, trying to work on a lot of stuff. And, with the task at hand right now, we got to be honest, right now, we just got to come out and compete.
Yeah.
At this point, we're probably already out of the district race, region race. We got to come out and compete each week, try to get better.
That's the idea. Really looking towards next year, I guess you could say. Warren County, as we heard on the pregame show, Pioneers are going to platoon tonight. 11 on offense, 11 on defense, or something like that.
Right. Try to rotate as in as many people as you can.
Try to keep everybody from getting just worn out. So we'll see.
That just get a lot of experience.
Yeah.
But we need more anything. You just play football.
A lot of young players starting this year. They're taking their lumps, but this is going to pay dividends the next couple of years if they stay with it. And the coin toss at midfield. While we're doing this, want to brag on our culinary arts class at Warren County High School. Again, they outdid themselves tonight in the press
really
box
did.
Meal.
Each time I asked Coach Lippy coming in, I said, can we have just 10 home games?
Yeah.
I mean, it's a lasagna tonight. Shout out to culinary arts.
Absolutely. Gallatin wins the toss. They elect to receive, so we'll see Warren County on defense first. We'll be back with a kickoff in just a moment.
Establish your credit. Come see us at Security Federal. We are the local bank with smiling faces, always happy to help you. See why we are known as the friendliest bank in town. Security Federal, member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Hi, this is Alex Nathan, Champion Chevrolet GMC of Edmundville. I want to personally invite you to our sizzling summer clearance sale. We've got the country's hottest small SUVs like the Chevy Trax and Trailblazer, and they start about $22,000. Or you can save up to $8,000 on the Silverado or Sierra. I'm Alex Nathan.
And I'm Amanda Nathan.
We put the family in family-owned business.
And our family will save your family a lot of money.
Champion of Edmundville, 1600 Sparta Street or championchevy.com.
92.1, The Ticket.
Back at Nunley Stadium. Good teams on their respective sidelines. Warren County will be on defense first.
Well, we had to start 30 minutes later just to get the buses and get down here. But, good crowd there. Wow, that's just for them to get the buses and...
Oh, touchdown, Gallatin.
Troop to Barksdale. Play covers 14 yards. Now Gallatin attempting the extra point. It is good.
He's got a leg. We watched him in pregame.
He sure does. Timeout on the field. 10 minutes to play in the opening quarter. It's Gallatin 7, Orange County nothing. Back in a moment.
Inventory is extremely low here at Ed Rogers Valley Ford. Ordering a new vehicle is a breeze. Ed Rogers Valley Ford is continuing to provide the best customer service from our fully trained new vehicle sales staff. Also, one of the largest pre-owned vehicle selections in the Upper Cumberland area with over 100 pre-owned vehicles to choose from. And don't forget, Ed Rogers Valley Ford will buy your car even if you don't buy theirs. Ed Rogers Valley Ford, Highway 111 across from the Walmart in Sparta, or visit us at edrogersvalleyford.com.
Have you been to Tea Time at the Elementary in Morrison? Whether you feel like visiting the driving range or hosting a tournament with friends, their outdoor-indoor golf simulator feels true to the game. Play with the stunning visual detail on more than 150 courses, both real-world and fictional. Challenge your friends to golf skills suited for beginners and pros, or get in some practice swings. Rain or shine, give them a call at 931-773-7529. Anytime is Tea Time.
92.1, The Ticket.
Board. Line drive kick. Wow. And that hit about 5 yards
out
in back of the end zone. Hit against the, bounced off the brick base of the scoreboard.
Wow. And that was a line shot.
That was a line drive. Wow. So 2 weeks in a row, we're facing a really good kicker. In fact, they've got a couple of good kickers on this Gallatin team. All right, Warren County coming with Brady Swallows, the sophomore quarterback. First and 10 from the Warren County 20. Two receivers right, two left. Warren County moving from your right to your left. Rolling left. And throwing down the sideline, Swallows, catch is made in Gallatin territory by Isaiah Robledo.
Good job, good pass.
First National Bank, first down, Pioneers. How's that for an opening play?
Absolutely beautiful. Their defensive backs are looking at each other like, what are we doing?
Swallows with good protection. Nice pass, and Robledo with the speed able to run under it. Two receivers right, two left. First down, Warren County at the 47 of Gallatin. And now a flag thrown. And it'll be a false start against Warren County. That will put the ball back at the Warren County 48. First and 15. Gallatin leading 7-0. Took them only 2 minutes to put it in the end zone.
Yeah, two big pass plays. Running game wasn't getting them much, but the pass plays did.
Receiver to the right-hand side. Swallows under center.
Apparently he hadn't watched that on film.
Yeah, Warren County is sending a couple of guys in motion. And Gallatin jumped, so Warren County will get that yardage back. Offsides is the call. First and 10 Pioneers at the Greenway, 47. Warren County lines it up. They come with two receivers on the right side. Robledo in the slot. Swallows, pitches, to Latina. That's going to go nowhere. Big loss on the play. That was, I believe, Mulligan. Not Latina.
Latina's wearing number 6.
Yes, he is. Big loss on that play. Back to the Warren County 43. Trying to sweep the right side, and it was not there. It'll be second down and about 20. Two receivers right, one left. Swallows in the shotgun, taking the snap, dropping back, getting pressure. Screen pass is going to be incomplete.
Almost overthrew it, almost picked off.
Yeah, Gallatin had that play perfectly. It was intended for Robledo, but even if he made the catch, he wasn't going anywhere.
No, had it well covered.
So it'll be third and 20 at the Warren County 43. Getting down close to the 8-minute mark in the first quarter. Gallatin leading 7-0. Warren County coming, two receivers left. Swallows under center. Now sends a man wide out to the right side. Man goes in motion. On the keeper, this is Swallows. He's in trouble, and he'll go down for a loss of a yard. May have been a busted play.
Yeah, I think it was that inside handoff again, and he still make the handoff.
So Warren County will be in punch formation after picking up a first down in the opening play. Dug it into punt. Back deep, you've got Tibbs and Stroop. Snap is there. The punt is away. It's going to be a short punt. Fair catch made at the 38-yard line. And so Gallatin will go to work, first and 10 from their own 38. Gallatin leading 7-0. 7:23 to go in the opening quarter here at Nunley Stadium. Gallatin coming with two receivers right, one left. Stroop in the shotgun. Brinkley lines up to the right of him. Give goes to Brinkley up the middle. Able to get some running room. Looked like Warren County was going to have him at the line of scrimmage, but he's able to sneak past the 40. Out to the 42.
He broke some tackles in there and looked like he's got a pioneer down.
Warren County player is down.
He's moving his leg, so.
Looks like he's being checked by the Gallatin trainer. And Warren County's training staff going to have a look at him. Injury timeout. We'll be right back. Gallatin leads 7-0. Injury timeout. We'll be right back. Gallatin leads 7-0.
Hi, I'm Tommy Foster, owner of Foster & Foster Realty and Auction Company. We understand that buying or selling a home is more than just a transaction. It is a life-changing experience. That's why our team of seasoned real estate professionals are dedicated to providing exceptional, personalized service. We take great pride in the relationships we build and always work relentlessly on the client's behalf to help them achieve their real estate goals. Let us be your real estate go-to. Give us a call at 473-6010. Foster & Foster.
Why won't this work?
Don't lose your cool. Call Blank's Heating and Air for a preseason check-in service on your central air conditioning system. It can increase the life and dependability of your unit while reducing the chances of a very sticky situation.
Unbelievable!
Get that air conditioner checked now.
This is Benny Black.
And this is Seth Black with Black's Heating Air.
Call today, 931-668-0785.
Benny's slogan at Black's Heating and Air is, once you've had Black, you won't go back.
Mention this ad and you can get a discount.
92.1, The Ticket.
Garrett Mitchell is the injured pioneer. He's being helped off the field by the Warren County training staff. Coach Matt Turner also out on the field having a look at him. Looks like he's walking under his own power.
Looks like he's
may
holding.
Have had his belt on.
Yeah, looks like he's holding his arm or wrist or something. Don't know.
Yeah, he is holding that right arm. It'll be second down four for Gallatin when we resume action. Coach Turner out having a word with the official.
I'm not sure what that's about.
Yeah, Mitchell's been off the field for a few seconds.
Other officials escorting him off. So
yeah.
Apparently he didn't like what went on at the pile there or something.
Yeah.
I don't know.
They're still talking. Matt's on the sideline, though. Two receivers stacked on the near side. Give goes to Brinkley straight ahead. Got some running room. Past the 50, the 40. It's a foot race to the 30, to the 20. And he'll be ridden down at about the 7. Brinkley is built like a fire plug. It'll be a first and goal for Gallatin. They'll mark him at the 8. Two receivers right side. Brinkley in the backfield. Stroop in the shotgun. He takes the snap, hands to Brinkley. Brinkley will bull his way into the end zone. Touchdown, Gallatin.
He is a strong runner.
He really is.
Short, round, and fast.
Brinkley with an 8-yard run for the second touchdown of the evening for Gallatin. 6:19 to go in the first quarter. Max Kelly in to attempt the extra point. Snap is down. And the kick is good. Timeout on the field. 6:19 to go in the first quarter. Your score, Gallatin 14, Warren Kelly nothing. Back in a moment.
Gallatin 14, Warren Kelly nothing. Back in a moment.
Citizens Tri-County Bank is proud to support Warren County Pioneer Athletics. These sports build character, integrity, and goodwill, all traits vital to success. It's the same mentality in which we do banking. Since 1972, Citizens Tri-County Bank has been serving customers across this region with the highest customer service standards. Stop by any of our four locations in McMinnville and Warren County and experience a different kind of banking atmosphere. Citizens Tri-County Bank, the only community bank you'll ever need. Equal housing lender, member FDIC.
My life is always on, every single day, and the electricity my co-op provides is more essential to it than ever before. It allows me to shop online while I'm watching TV and keeps my mobile phone charged so I can return the 10 missed calls from my mother. I depend on the electricity from my co-op to power my life and keep me connected every single day. Learn more about the power of your co-op membership at togetherwesave.com.
Call Caney Fork Electric at 473-3116.
92.1, The Ticket.
Another line drive kick. And once again, goes through the end zone. That time hitting about 9 yards deep in the end zone. Not a very good kick for Kelly.
That wasn't near as good as the first one, was it?
So another touchback for the Pioneers. They'll start at their own 20. Gallatin now leading 14-0.
Yeah, that's a... Big plays, and that's what they've got. Really look at what scored on three big plays, two big pass plays first series and a big run play the second one.
You know, you look at teams like Gallatin and Warren County gets an idea of what they want to be.
Yeah, absolutely.
Warren County sends a wide out to the near side or left side. Swallows under center. Now a wide out to the right side. Inside handoff goes to Robledo. He's got running room. 25 to the 30. Out past the 30, and that should be enough for a first down.
The inside handoff, we've seen that trap play. It's worked once or twice this year. Good yardage on that one.
First National Bank first down for the Pioneers. Robledo moves it out to the 33. Just under 6 minutes to play in the first quarter here at Nunley Stadium. Gallatin leads it 14-0. The Pioneers come with two receivers left. Swallows in the shotgun. Swallows taking the snap. Quick pass to the near side. It's going to be incomplete.
Had it. He just dropped it.
Intended for Mulligan. Had it right in his hands. He's mad at himself.
I'm throwing him gloves down. I don't think it's a gloves fault.
He's got to get over that. Burn that bridge, as the coach says. He was about to be hit. In fact, he was hit. At least second down 10. Swallows under center. Man goes in motion. Pitch goes to the motion man, trying the right side. Gets to the outside and is pushed out of bounds after a gain of about 4. Christopher Robledo on the carry. They'll give him 3 yards. It's going to be 3rd down and 7 from the Pioneer 36. 5:21 to go in the opening quarter. 14-0 Gallatin. Horry County coming with 2 receivers to the left side. Swallows in the shotgun, takes the snap, drops back to throw. Looking, throwing, incomplete. Pass a little high for his target, Isaiah Robledo. And it'll be 4th down.
Really, we're lucky there. That green wave defender there, if he had been reading the ball, it could have been intercepted.
Right. Dug it in to punt. Back deep, you've got Jeremiah Williams. Duggan standing at his own 21. High snap, and now flags on the play.
Get us for movement. They did a lot of dancing around on the defensive line, but
offsides is a call against Gallatin. Oh, wow. Still won't give Warren County a 1st down. Making it 4th and 2.
Now they're going to put the offense on, though.
It's looking like it. So Warren County will go for it on 4th and 2 from their own 41. Well, showing some confidence in the offense. Might try a hard count right here. Try to draw him off. Wide out to the near side. Swallows under center. Swallows with a long count. Going to take timeout, and they could not draw them offsides.
Hey, we tried, didn't we?
Yeah, tried to overload the left side like we did earlier, which drew them offsides.
I believe if we had that motion from the left side over the right side, we'd have drew that guy off again.
Yep. So timeout has been asked for. Gallatin leading 14-0. We'll be right back.
From 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. Monday is meatloaf, Tuesday ham, Wednesday fried pork chops, Thursday turkey and dressing, and Friday catfish. Mudbum's Family Sports Grill is located in the Northgate Shopping Center. Give them a call at 931-507-2867 or just come to the place to be just winging it.
Come on in and see how good it feels.
You'll always be treated right when you arrive at Ed Rogers Chevrolet Buick. With the new Chevrolet and Buick vehicles, plus a great selection of quality used vehicles. At Ed Rogers Chevrolet Buick, there's also an outstanding service department, proud to be family-owned for over 50 years.
So come on in and see how good it feels.
Get that great feeling of saving money today at Ed Rogers Chevrolet Buick in Sparta and edrogerschevy.net.
92.1, The Ticket.
Punted that one to the cheerleaders.
Yeah. The officials still walking across the way. Wow. And they'll give him the 43-yard line in Gallatin territory. So first and 10 Gallatin at their own 43. Green Wave coming with two receivers right, one left. Stroop in the shotgun. Stroop, quick pass to the far side. It's going to be complete. He'll finally be run out of bounds over on the far side.
We had him right there at the line of scrimmage, yeah, too.
That was LaDainian McMurray on the completion, on the reception. And it's going to be second and one in Warren County territory at the 47. Two receivers right, one left. Stroop going to throw over the middle, and it's going to be complete for a first down in Warren County territory at the 32. Warren County comes up with the football. They say it's a fumble. No indication from the official.
I think just the official over here said he was down.
Yeah, looked like a Pioneer came out with the ball. But they say he was down. It's going to be a first down for Gallatin. Gallatin's ball at the Warren County 32. Two receivers left, one right. Stroop gonna hand up the middle to Brinkley. Gets it past the 30, down to the 28. It'll be second down, six.
I think that could have almost been a fumble. It looked like he was bobbling the ball, and the Pioneer defender come up with it as he was going down to the ground.
Getting down to the three-minute mark in the first quarter. Gallatin leading 14-0. They've got it second and six at the Warren County 28. Pitch goes to the near side. Now cuts upfield. Got a lot of running room. He will take it to the end zone. Touchdown, Gallatin.
Just jet sweep. He was running to the sideline, seen the open seam, put his foot in the ground, and went straight north to the end zone.
That is Jeremiah Williams with a 28-yard touchdown run. It comes with 2:51 to go in the opening quarter. Kelly in to attempt the extra point. It's good. Timeout on the field. 2:51 to go in the first quarter. It's now Gallatin 21. Warren County nothing. Back in a moment.
Warren County nothing. Back in a moment.
Hi, this is Alex Nathan, Champion Chevrolet GMC of Edmundville. I want to personally invite you to our sizzling summer clearance sale. We've got the country's hottest small SUVs like the Chevy Trax and Trailblazer, and they start about $22,000. Or you can save up to $8,000 on a Silverado or Sierra. I'm Alex Nathan.
And I'm Amanda Nathan.
We put the family in family-owned business.
And our family will save your family a lot of money.
Champion of Edmundville, 1600 Sparta Street or championchevy.com.
Hello, Rhonda Walker here with Citizens Tri-County Bank. If you have mortgage needs and are looking for someone who will work hard for you, please stop by and see me. We offer conventional as well as all types of government loans, VA, FHA, and rural development. And if your work hours make it hard to visit us in person, we have a mobile app we can share with you so you can apply anytime, even nights or on the weekend. Just give us a call and we'll promptly make our mobile app available to you. We are a community bank that cares about personal relationships, and we want to get to know you, whether we do it in person or online. Member FDIC and Equal Opportunity Lender.
92.1 The Ticket.
Kelly, every possession they've had the ball. And again, you'll put it through the end zone. And kicked it right to his manager, who was standing about 3 yards behind the end zone.
Yeah, that's it.
I don't think Warren County is going to return a kick tonight.
Not on by, unless he makes it on purpose.
Yeah. First and 10 Pioneers at their own 20. 2:51 to go in the first quarter. Wideouts left and right for the Pioneers. Swallows under center. Swallows hands to the tailback. That is, I believe, Latina. And he gets nowhere.
Going back to the standardized I formation, fullback, tailback, and he was met in the backfield.
That is Cal Latina. No gain on the play. In fact, he'll lose a yard. Making it second down, 11. Swallows bringing the play in. Warren County lines it up, second down, 11. Swallows under center, sends a man in motion, pitches to the motion man, trying the near side. That is Robledo, and he can't get to the corner. That's not Robledo. That is Harris.
Just didn't have the speed to get him. We think he's got speed, but he didn't have the speed to get to the edge.
This defense has got a lot of speed. Third down, 11. A minute and a half left to play in the opening quarter, 21-0, Gallatin. Got a receiver to the right side. Swallows under center, sends a man in motion. Fakes to him, going to throw it downfield. This will be caught. What a catch. What a catch by Mullicutt. At the 49-yard line, he was sliding down when he brought it in.
Yeah, he had to stop his route and come back, and man, what a catch. Swallow just threw it up, hoping somebody would run underneath, and he did.
First National Bank first down for the Pioneers at their own 49. Good concentration by Mullicutt.
Yeah, it really was for him to come back to the ball.
Two receivers right, two left. Swallows in the shotgun, takes the snap. Rolling right, turns it upfield. He'll be dragged down by the shirt tail at the 44. Looked like he might have had a hole to run through, but somebody grabbed a
pulled
a jersey and pulled him down. Second down, 15. From the Warren County 44. And Warren County may let the clock run out here as the first quarter will come to an end. That will be the end of the first quarter. Your score at the end of one, Gallatin 21, Warren County nothing. Back in a moment.
Warren County nothing. Back in a moment.
Tired of waiting on that IT company to finally get to your issue? Sick of having someone or yourself having to wear the IT hat? Well, in the words of Uncle Joey, cut it out. Ben Lomond Connect's managed IT team is here. From security awareness training, firewall installation and management, antivirus and malware protection updates, to disaster recovery, cloud backup, and much more, you can let the BLC managed IT crew carry the load for a single project or every day. So cut it out and replace it with BLC's managed IT. For more, go to BenLomondConnect.com. Some exclusions may apply.
Mudbum's Family Sports Grill is now offering a meat and three for only $10, Monday through Friday from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. Monday is meatloaf, Tuesday ham, Wednesday fried pork chops, Thursday turkey and dressing, and Friday catfish. Mudbum's Family Sports Grill is located in the Northgate Shopping Center. Give them a call at 931-507-2867 or just come to the place to be just winging it.
92.1, The Ticket.
John Harris Middle School out of Shelbyville. Next Thursday night here at Nunley Stadium, starting time 6:30. And my understanding, we'll have the game on WCS-TV Channel 180. Warren County now moving from your left to your right. Second and 15 from the 44.
Middle School's had a very good year.
They have. Swallows under center. Swallows going to pass. It is going to be incomplete.
That defender went in head high.
He sure did. Intended for Robledo. It'll be third and 15. Warren County with three first downs in the first half. They seem to be able to get one first down and then drive stalls, but see if they can pick it up here.
At minus 1 yard rushing, first half, 63 yards passing.
Two receivers left. Swallows in the shotgun. Swallows. Rolling left, throws. It is going to be incomplete. Intended for Mulligan. Pass was off the mark. And it will be fourth and 15. So the punt team getting in the game.
Gallatin had 186 yards of offense in the first quarter.
Duggan standing at his own 30, takes the snap, boots it away. It'll be dropped, picked it, bobbled, there's a scramble for it. Warren County says they've got it. And they've got it.
Good deal. Gallatin had a trick play on there. You've seen the two guys over here.
Yeah.
They were going to try something funny on that play, and the guy was looking at his other players before he caught the ball.
That was Jeremiah Williams trying to catch it. He bobbled it and tried to get it again, bobbled it again. And then there was a scramble after that. Warren County came out with it. So good field position for the Pioneers at the Gallatin 23. Warren County coming with wideouts left and right. Swallows under center. Throwing over the middle, it is complete, I think.
Yep.
Makes the catch at the 15. I believe that was Robledo making the catch. Rather Latina. So it'll be a gain of 8, second down 2. Second and 2 Pioneers from the Gallatin 15. Wide out left for the Pioneers. Swallows in the shotgun, taking the snap, rolling right. Dumps it off short, and this will be a loss on the play as it's completed at the 19 to Caleb Cox.
Yeah, it wasn't. I think Swallows wanted to get rid of it.
It's going to be third and 6 from the 19. Caleb Cox, of course, scored that last touchdown last week, last play of the game, rumbling 65 yards.
Yeah.
Third down and 6 Pioneers from the Gallatin 19. They come with a receiver to the right side. Swallows in the shotgun. Hands it off. Nowhere to go. He will lose yardage. Back to the 21. That was Latina. That defensive front got in there in a hurry.
Yeah, it did.
It will be fourth and 7. Warren County going for it on 4th and 7 from the Gallatin 21. Two receivers right, 2 left. Swallows rolling left. Looking, throwing, and incomplete. Had a man open right at the first down marker, but the pass a little bit short, and so the ball goes over.
had somebody out there, just I don't think he would have got a first down, though, so a little bit short. His rollouts are his best option right now. Standing in the pocket's not an option, but if we can keep him rolling out like that, as long as we can set the edge, he can give him a little bit of time.
Best field position of the night for the Pioneers, but they could not take advantage. And so Gallatin gets it back, first and 10 from their own 20. Two receivers right, one left. Gallatin now moving from your right to your left. Stroop in the shotgun. Takes the snap and a handoff to Brinkley, trying the right side, running over tacklers as he gets it past the 25 to the 26.
He's a bruising back.
As we said, he's built like a fire plug. He's just running over people. It'll be second down four from the 27. Two receivers left, one right. Stroop back to throw, pass to the near side. It's going to be caught by Williams. He'll work it past the 30 out to the 35. That'll be a first down for the Green Wave.
Good stop and change of direction there.
First and 10, Gallatin. That is their fourth first down of the game. Two receivers right, one left. Give goes to Brinkley. Trying the middle, nothing there. That time he's met by a red wall of Pioneers. Again, a Pioneer comes out with the ball, but he was down. It will be second and 10. Make it second and 9 from the Gallatin 36. Gallatin leads 21-0. Stroop taking the snap, dropping back. Going long, and this will be incomplete, and a flag on the play as Warren County will be guilty of pass interference.
That may be a good pass interference right there.
Yeah.
He definitely had a step on us, and that would have been a touchdown.
Braden Knight got a little handful of jersey there.
Yeah, but still, I think that might have been a good
penalty. It might have been a good move. Because if he catches that, he's probably going to take it to the end zone. That'll put the ball at the Warren County 49. First and 10, Gallatin. Two receivers right, one left for the Green Wave. Stroop in the shotgun. He'll hand to Brinkley straight ahead. Again, he's met by that brick wall of Pioneer red jerseys. He'll get about a yard. Warren County's getting some confidence out there on defense.
Yeah, they really are.
It'll be second down 9 from the 48. Two receivers right, one left. Brinkley lines up on the right side of Stroop. Stroop taking the snap, dropping back, looking to throw. Directing traffic, throws, got a man on the sideline, 40 to the 30 and out of bounds inside the 30.
Flag.
We got a flag on the play back at the 40. Back to the Gallatin 40. Roughing the passer. So that'll be declined. And Gallatin will have another first down. They'll mark the ball at the Warren County 28. Two receivers left, one right. They stack two receivers on the near side. Stroop Takes the handoff, throwing over the middle. Got a man wide open. Touchdown, Gallatin.
Make it look easy, don't they?
That is Abe Goolsby bringing it in. He had nobody within 5 yards of it.
Yeah.
Stroop to Goolsby. Play covering 28 yards. Now Kelly in to attempt the extra point.
They put it on the street.
And he puts it up in the bushes. Snap is down, the kick is good. Timeout of the field, 6:33 to go in the half. It's Gallatin 28, Warren County nothing. Back in a moment.
Go in the half, it's Gallatin 28, Warren County nothing. Back in a moment.
Need a fun place for the whole family? Look no further. Check out Detention at the Elementary is your family entertainment center fun for the whole family. You can grab a bite on the all-you-can-eat salad bar or check out their menu and hit the arcade, eat, play, repeat. It's that simple. Whether it's a birthday party, special events, or a night out, there's fun to be had for all ages. Give them a call today at 931-773-7529.
No more sorting meds, waiting in line, or chasing down refills. Graves Family Pharmacy is now offering Pack My Meds, an easy way to take your daily medication. Here's how it works. We work directly with your doctors to save you time and frustration. We monitor and sort all of your prescriptions and supplements by date and time. Organize them into pouch packages so you can pick them up with no wait. No more requests for refills and no more sorting. The best part? We offer this service at no extra cost to our patients. We do it all for you at Graves Family Pharmacy. Call us at 473-6418. Our goal with Pack My Meds is to simplify your life.
92.1, the ticket.
Nothing. Still 6:33 to go in the first half. Kelly's set to kick off with a green wave. Let's see how far he kicks this one. Not quite as far, but still in the end zone.
It was going south and made it more of a breeze.
So another touchback. Warren County will have it first and 10 at their own 20. Next Friday night, we're on the road. First of three straight on the road as Warren County begins the second half of the season. Hard to believe, isn't it?
It really is. We always say it when the season starts, it's like you snap your fingers.
Yeah.
We're halfway through and then we're done.
Warren County goes to Cookeville next Friday night. Warren County comes with one wide out to the near side. Pioneers moving from your left to your right. Swallows under center. Sends a man in motion. Pitches to the motion man. No, he didn't. He handed it off.
Yeah, it's that inside trap that went nowhere.
It's going to be a loss of at least two. Second down, 12 for the Pioneers.
Like Latino's out right now.
He's getting looked at over here by the trainer. Second down, 12 from the 18. Ten on the play clock. Warren County lines it up. Two receivers left. Swallows under center. Now jumps back in the shotgun. Going to have to hurry. And it's going to be a delay of game on the Pioneers. Nope. Coach Turner got a timeout. Timeout in the field. 5:39 to go in the half. 28-0 Gallatin. Back in a moment.
Your first home, or maybe downsizing or upgrading from your current home. Is it just time for a change? Paul Holder Realty and Auction Company can answer all your questions about buying or selling. Paul Holder Realty and Auction Company is a family-owned business that's been serving Middle Tennessee since 1955. Stop by their office today at 108 East Main Street in McMinnville, or give them a call at 931-473-7321 to get the area's hardest working real estate company working for you. Firm license number 33.
Why did you open up Newt's Barbecue in Rock Island?
I wanted to share some old-time recipes that came from my family and other people around here that's been in business a long time.
And what makes your barbecue so good?
Well, it goes back about 30 years ago when Pope Taylor taught me to barbecue. Been barbecuing ever since.
What are your hours of operation?
Right now, we're running every day except Tuesday, 11 to 7. If you're running late and call me, I'll wait on you. So I'm not a restaurant. I'm a kitchen away from my home.
92.1 The Ticket.
It will be second and 12 from the Pioneers, for the Pioneers from their own 18. Gallatin leading 28-0 here in the second quarter. Warren County coming with a receiver to the near side. Swallows under center, sends the man in motion. Swallows wanting to throw. Going along down the sideline, that is deflected and incomplete.
Defender, Legarius Humphrey. And it'll be third and 12. Christopher Robledo, the intended receiver. So third and 12 from the 18.
With Latino being on the sideline, that takes one of our big major weapons, yeah, receivers out, so.
Third and 12, Warren County coming with a wide out to the left side. Swallows under center, now the wide out moves to the right side. Swallows back to throw, rolling right, getting pressure from behind, now throwing long down the sideline. It is deflected and a flag on the play. This will be defensive pass interference.
Well, he was all over him, wasn't he?
He was. That is Marshall Hansen getting a little anxious there for Gallatin. So a break for the Pioneers. Defensive pass interference is the call. We'll see where they mark it.
That 15-yard penalty. Yeah.
Should be around the 35.
Didn't really get much of a replay there.
Well, they'll put it down to 33. So first and 10 Pioneers. First National Bank first out. We'll take it however we can get it.
Absolutely.
First and 10 at the Pioneer 33. 5:24 to go in the half. Gallatin leading 28-0. Pioneers come with two receivers left. Swallows in the shotgun, drops back, throws, complete. Near the far sideline, run out of bounds at the 40. Pass is complete to Brian Holtwood.
Really surprised the Pioneers are not letting that play clock work on down.
Yeah.
Try to use all the clock they can to try to keep Gallatin's offense off the field.
It's going to be second down and 3. That's the Warren County 40. Two receivers right. Swallows in the shotgun. Swallows throws to the near side. It's going to be incomplete.
Dropped it.
In and out of the hands of Harris.
It's a good ball, good throw there, good route. He just dropped the ball.
Third and 3 from the 40.
Been a first down.
Clock stopped, 4:39 to go in the first half, 28-0, Gallatin. Warren County coming with two receivers right, two left. High snap for Swallows. He's going to have to jump on it.
Ball's
still loose, and it's going to be picked up by Gallatin. He'll be tackled at the Warren County 19.
It's a high snap there, and he had no chance.
Chris Boyd, 5'10", 315, linebacker, is the one that pounced on it.
315 linebacker, that's just unreal.
Yeah. He's the one Coach Turner was talking about in the pregame. We're going to have to watch out for him. So a turnover by the Pioneers. The snap over Swallow's head. We've got a timeout called. 4:30 to go. We'll take timeout. 28-0 Gallatin. Back in a moment.
Well, they brought the blitz right there.
Nothing says how much someone means to you quite like the gift of fine jewelry. And no one knows that better than Diamond Jewelry Company. For over 60 years, Diamond Jewelry has been there for that nervous engagement, the wedding vows, the anniversaries, the moms, daughters, and those special I love yous. David Stinson is a fourth generation jeweler committed to making those events the very best. Come see their showroom of one-of-a-kind jewelry in downtown McMinnville or follow them on Facebook and Instagram. Diamond Jewelry Company. They sell memories.
Want to know how you can earn $1 credit every month? Change your billing preference to emailed bill or e-bill. You can start adding to your piggy bank $1 each month just for choosing e-bill with MES. And by the way, e-bill has other advantages. You get to see your bill sooner, as soon as it's produced, no need to wait on the mail. You get to view your bill from your email on your computer or on your smartphone. Use the MES Power app to change your preference from paper to e-bill and earn $1 a month. Who says a dollar doesn't buy much? Shining the light on your future since 1939.
92.1, The Ticket.
Walking under his own power, but still being assisted. Tough night for Warren County injury-wise.
It is.
Had at least three go down. Back to throw, Stroop throws to the end zone, and it's going to be caught for a touchdown. What a catch.
Wow.
Good coverage by Warren County, but LaDainian McMurray reaching over the defender to pull it down. That comes with 4:24 to go in the half. Yeah, Warren County had the coverage, but he just outleaped it. Kelly in to attempt the extra point.
They have some athletes like it.
Snap is down. The kick is good. Timeout of the field. 4:24 to go in the half. It is now Gallatin 35. Warren County nothing. Back in a moment.
35. Warren County nothing. Back in a moment.
No more sorting meds, waiting in line, or chasing down refills. Graves Family Pharmacy is now offering Pack My Meds, an easy way to take your daily medication. Here's how it works. We work directly with your doctors to save you time and frustration. We monitor and sort all of your prescriptions and supplements by date and time. Organize them into pouch packages so you can pick them up with no wait. No more requests for refills and no more sorting. The best part? We offer this service at no extra cost to our patients. We do it all for you at Graves Family Pharmacy. Call us at 473-6418. Our goal with Pack My Meds is to simplify your life.
At Heise Incorporated, we serve families of all faiths. We follow your directions down to the very smallest of details. At Heise Incorporated, we'll never tell you what to do, and we don't pass judgment. We simply listen to your concerns, answer your questions, and then stand by your side as you navigate the difficult pathway of planning final arrangements after a loved one has been lost. Heise Incorporated, serving McMinnville and the surrounding areas since 1925. We serve because we care.
92.1, The Ticket.
Fast second half, Jeff Lee.
Yeah, unfortunately, but Gallatin's a very good football team. Well,
they really are.
They got all kinds of athletes, and Warren County seem to be dropping pretty quick.
Kelly kicks it off, and that will go through the end zone. He has not had a kickoff return yet tonight.
And will not unless he chooses to kick it short.
He'll have to be his decision, I guess. Warren County has it first and 10 at their own 20, trailing 35 to nothing. Warren County to the line, two receivers left and two right. Swallows in the shotgun. Swallows drops back to throw, getting rushed. And he'll throw it away.
big linebacker fell on him too.
Yeah, I think fans, some of the fans might have been wanting a penalty, but no penalty. Second and 10 from the 20. They'll be honoring the class of 83, or the Pioneer team of 1983 at halftime. Good football team.
In the early 80s, there's a lot of good football teams
sure
come
was.
Through.
Second and 10. Warren County coming with trips to the left side. One receiver right. Another bad snap. Swallows trying to cover it. It's going to be covered in the end zone by Gallatin.
Swallows
for
are trying
a touchdown.
To cover it and end up kicking it.
Yeah.
But unacceptable. That's two bad snaps there over his head.
Abe Goolsby falls on it in the end zone. Well, when it's your night, it's your night. That comes with 4:11 to go in the half. So another bad snap over the head of Swallows. He tried to fall on it at the 5-yard line, accidentally kicked it. Here's the extra point, and it is good. Timeout on the field, 4:11 to go in the half. Gallatin leading 42-0. Back in a moment.
Gallatin leading 42-0. Back in a moment.
Celebration season is here, and College River Barbecue has got you covered. Treat your guests with hickory smoked barbecue made from scratch sides and desserts. College River Barbecue has perfect and private upstairs venue ready for any occasion. You can have business events, graduations, meetings, parties, and even baby showers conveniently located in historic downtown McMinnville. Need somewhere for your guests to stay? College River also has a short-term rentals. College River thrives to make your event delicious, memorable, and stress-free. Give them a call, 507-3663, or check out their website at CollinsRiverBBQ.com.
Every day, banks touch every corner of our lives. Let me, Sabrina Keaton, help you turn your life goals into accomplishments. Here at Security Federal Savings Bank, we can assist you with buying a car, debt consolidation, purchasing a home, or remodeling your current home. Whatever your needs are, we will keep it simple at Security Federal Savings Bank. We look forward to serving you and building relationships that last generations. Security Federal Savings Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
92.1, The Ticket.
Gallatin leading 42-0. Kelly in to kick off.
Offensive line's getting too big of a trying to get those blitzing linebackers, and defensive line are just not paying attention.
Kicks a squibber, and that'll go through the end zone.
Like a fastball squibber, wouldn't
wow.
it?
Wow, I wouldn't want to be in front of that one. Another touchback. Warren County will have it at their own 20, first and 10. Thought he might be feeling benevolent and want to let us return one, but not yet.
We'd like to thank our season field sponsor, Morrison Industries.
4:11 o'clock. It's been all Gallatin tonight. Good football team, as they usually are. Warren County lines it up. Receiver to the near side. Swallows under center. He will hand it off. Hit in the backfield, and down he goes.
Well, Gallatin defense putting on a highlight reel, too.
That was P.J. Truex. He had nowhere to go. We'll see where they mark him. Definitely a loss on the play. They'll put it down at the 18. Actually, the 19, second down, 11. Two receivers right, two left. Swallows in the shotgun. Sends a man in motion. Swallows taking the snap. Dumps it off short. It is incomplete. Trying to get it to Harris.
Swallows pass intended for
He was smothered immediately.
Yeah, I don't think that would have got very far, would it?
It would not. Third down, 11. .320 showing on the clock here in the first half. Gallatin leads it 42-0. Warren County coming with trips to the right side. One receiver left. They're blitzing. Screen pass is going to be intercepted by Gallatin. He'll be taken down at the 5-yard line. Santana Banks says, look what I found. A deflected pass went right in his hands.
Wow.
And again, it's one of those nights for the Pioneers. If something could go wrong, it's going wrong.
Yeah, that's just unreal.
Gallatin not needing breaks, but they're getting them. Gallatin comes with trips to the left side, one receiver right. New running back in the game, Jaden Hoskins. Stroop taking the snap, pass to the near side, incomplete. Intended for Jay Ellis, and he can't hang on to it.
Might have been his first incomplete.
Yeah. Clock stop, 3:09 to go in the half. Gallatin has it at the Warren County 10-yard line. Second and goal. And I think we had somebody move a little early for Gallatin.
That offensive line may have went a little bit, a few steps too soon.
Procedure penalty against Gallatin. 4 penalties for 30 yards for the Green Wave. Hasn't hurt him. They'll put the ball back to the 15, second and goal. Two receivers right, two left. Gift goes to Hoskins, turns it outside, and he will dive for the pylon. Did he get in?
Mark him short.
Apparently not. I think he may have stepped out of bounds at about the 4.
He just kept bouncing it outside. Pioneers kept sticking it, but he finally made the turn.
To be third and goal from the 4. Two receivers left. Brinkley back in the game. He'll hand to Brinkley, and he'll take it to the end zone. Gallatin on the board again. With 2 minutes to go in the half. Brinkley with a 4-yard run for the touchdown. That is his second touchdown of the evening. Kelly in to attempt the extra point. Snap is down. And the kick is good. Timeout on the field. 2 minutes to go in the half. It's now 49-0. Gallatin back in a moment.
Insurance is never far away. Your local agent, Kevin Roten, is just up the road. Located at 6282 Manchester Highway, that's the light at Bridgestone, Farm Bureau Insurance has you covered for auto, home, and life insurance. For a free quote and great customer service, stop by the Farm Bureau office in Morrison today or call 668-7075, because at the end of the day, we treat people right, and that's why we're Tennessee's insurance company.
Want to know how you can earn $1 credit every month? Change your billing preference to emailed bill or e-bill. You can start adding to your piggy bank $1 each month just for choosing eBill with MES. And by the way, eBill has other advantages.
You get to see your bill sooner, as soon as it's produced, no need to wait on the mail. You get to view your bill from your email on your computer or on your smartphone. Use the MES Power app to change your preference from paper to e-bill and earn $1 a month. Who says a dollar doesn't buy much? Shining the light on your future since 1939.
92.1, The Ticket.
Gallatin.
Seventh, eighth time.
Gallatin now leading 49-0. Forget about this one. It will fall just at the base of the goalpost for a touchback. Wow, seven kickoffs for Kelly and none returned. Got a feeling he'll be kicking on Saturdays in the future.
Yeah, absolutely.
We'll He's be, only we'll a junior.
Be, we'll be seeing him. We can see him again next year and then we'll be watching him later.
First and 10, Warren County at their own 20. Two receivers right, two left. 2 minutes to go in the half. Swallows in the shotgun, taking the snap, rolling right. Now he's going to tuck it and run. Swallows getting
to get
a
down.
Couple. They never could get him down before the whistle blew. So they'll give him about three. It'll be second down seven.
Quarterback coach is telling him he's got to get down.
Clock running, 1:26 to go. Warren County not in any big hurry. Play clock down to 10. They might want to think about hurrying now. Play clock down to 3. 2-1. And the Pioneers will take a timeout. 1:06 to go in the half. It is 49-0 Gallatin. Back in a moment. It's 49-0 Gallatin. Back in a moment.
During these times we live in, where new vehicle inventory is extremely low, here at Ed Rogers Valley Ford, ordering a new vehicle is a breeze. Ed Rogers Valley Ford is continuing to provide the best customer service from our fully trained new vehicle sales staff. Also, one of the largest pre-owned vehicle selections in the Upper Cumberland area, with over 100 pre-owned vehicles to choose from. And don't forget, Ed Rogers Valley Ford will buy your car even if you don't buy theirs. Ed Rogers Valley Ford, Highway 111 across from the Walmart in Sparta, or visit us at edrogersvalleyford.com.
Why did you open up Newt's Barbecue in Rock Island?
I wanted to share some old-time recipes that came from my family and other people around here that's been in business a long time.
And what makes your barbecue so good?
Well, it goes back about 30 years ago when Pope Taylor taught me to barbecue. Been barbecuing ever since.
What are your hours of operation?
Right now, we're running every day except Tuesday, 11 to 7. If you're running late and call me, I'll wait on you. So that I'm not a restaurant. I'm a kitchen away from my home.
92.1, The Ticket.
Swallows.
Good arm, though.
Yeah.
Brings up third.
It will be third and seven from the Pioneer 23.
Kid can definitely throw the ball. That's a
just under a minute to play in the half. Pioneers come with a wide out to the left side. Swallows under center. Swallows sends a man in motion. Rolling to the right side, getting pressure. And he'll step out of bounds at around the 20.
Smart move.
That'll bring a fourth down with 53 seconds left to play in the half. Now Duggan coming in to punt. And if you're a Warren County fan, you're hoping Gallatin won't get another chance at the end zone. They're very explosive, as we have seen tonight. J.C. Cagle, one of the deep men. Punt is away, wobbly kick. Cagle calling for a fair catch and makes it at the 48-yard line. So first and 10, Gallatin at their own 48, 46 seconds left to play.
Number 33 for the Pioneers, Garrett Duggan, with a 31-yard punt.
Pretty good. He's been kicking the ball well this year.
He really has.
Had a couple of games where he averaged almost 40.
Stroop still in the game. Two receivers right, two left. Sends a man in motion, pitches to the motion man, trying the far side. Slips away from one tackler, still on his feet. Still on his feet, down the sideline to the 30, to the 20, and finally run out of bounds.
Wow, we had a couple of chances to get him there, but
34 seconds still to play in the half. The first down for Gallatin at the Warren County 14. Ball carrier was Jay Ellis. Now they got Brinkley back hit. And they may just take the knee right here. Got a man way back at the 30, and he's going to take a knee. And that'll be the last play of the half. Or it should be.
Should be. Yeah, they're going to lock her in.
Yeah, so Gallatin's coach feeling a little benevolent here. We have reached halftime. Your score, Gallatin 49, Warren County nothing. Back with halftime in just a moment.
Is your money just sitting in an account not earning any interest? Coffee Bank and Trust offers the best rates for your checking, savings, and money market accounts. Now you can sit back and watch your money grow. Coffee Bank and Trust, a division of Coffee County Bank, your local banking solution. Member FDIC.
Hi folks, Trisha here with Jason Lewis Chrysler Dodge Jeep and Ram during our Ram Power Days.
That's right, come check out the difference, folks. Right now we've got discounts and savings of up to $15,000 off. And at Jason Lewis Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram, we always pay you more for your trade.
Plus, new cars come with our exclusive 1 million mile, 10 year warranty.
On Highway 111, across from Super Walmart in Sparta, Tennessee.
And online anytime at Jason Lewis Automotive.
92.1, The Ticket.
Thank you.
they are, those team members are on the field here at halftime, and a good turnout.
Absolutely, good crowd.
So they're having their names called out and getting applause from the fans here. And again, as you mentioned, in the early 80s, it was the heyday of Warren County football.
It really was. Warren County, the 80s, they were a powerhouse. Went to won a lot of games in then, and really started about 91, kind of went downhill from there. I think we've only had, like, I think one of our friends quoted 71 wins since 91 area. Wow. So it's not been a very good pioneer since then. But a lot of time, we got to give these teams credit from back in the 80s, but we really need to be focusing on how we can help build our teams now.
Yep. And I think the coach, Coach Matt Turner talked to the Rotary Club yesterday, stressing the importance of our Pioneer Youth Football, which is really taken off this year. Parents are excited about it. You know, you come out on Saturdays and you see the teams, the nice uniforms, and really getting a lot of attention from the community. And you know, this is gonna continue.
And it needs to. You know, our youth program needs to be a mirror image of what our middle school and our high school program is. Same terminology, same play, same this and that. That way, when they get to the middle school, they know what they're doing. When they get to the high school, they know what they're doing.
Exactly.
You know, you go look at a Maryville, look at all their youth program. I guarantee you go to Gallatin and look at all the youth programs up there, and they're doing the same thing.
Oh, yeah. We went to Lebanon. Remember all the kids in blue jerseys running out onto the field at halftime or
Absolutely.
Before the game. You know, and I hope that they'll let our kids do that at the next home game. I don't know if they have that
they
plan
really,
or not.
Yeah, they really need to do that.
It would be a good thing. But,
until we can get a youth program started, until we can really get focused on that to help get into the middle school, know what we're doing, you know, it's going to be the same thing. When you bring a kid out in high school that started playing football in high school, he really doesn't have a chance to succeed.
Yeah. But kids, you know, the young kids, they'll know what's expected of them. They'll know how tough it is. They'll know if they enjoy it or not. And obviously, a lot of these kids are enjoying it. I know the parents are. And so, that's something we've been missing for the last several years in Warren County. Is, you know, we've had the feeder program at the middle school, but really you need to get them started earlier than that.
They really do. We really need – I've always said we need a class at the middle school or somewhere, football 101, and just teach the basics of football.
Yeah.
You know, because a lot of kids, we get them when they come out and middle school and high school that haven't played, they don't know the little things, you know, the first and 10, what you need here and there. We need a football 101 basic class.
Again, Thursday night we'll have here on WCS TV channel 180, we'll bring you coverage of the middle school Pioneers playoff game with Harris Middle School out of Shelbyville. That'll be Thursday night at 6:30 here at Nunley Stadium. Hope you can come out and support these kids in person, but if not, you can watch us on television and YouTube. Gallatin band about to perform. We'll take us a break. We'll come back with more here at halftime in just a moment. Gallatin leads it 49-0 here at the half.
Hi, this is Alex Nafe at Champion Chevrolet GMC of Edmundville. I want to personally invite you to our sizzling summer clearance sale. We've got the country's hottest small SUVs like the Chevy Trax and Trailblazer, and they start about $22,000. Or you can save up to $8,000 on the Silverado or Sierra. I'm Alex Nafe.
And I'm Amanda Nafe.
We put the family in family-owned business.
And our family will save your family a lot of money.
Champion of Edmundville. 1600 Sparta Street or championchevy.com.
Home is where the heart is. It's also where your valuables, your vehicle, and your family is. So it's safe to say, if it's at home, you probably want to protect it. Luckily, no matter where your home is or the things that matter the most, Farm Bureau Insurance is never far away. Your local agent, Kevin Roten, is just up the road. Located at 6282 Manchester Highway, that's the light at Bridgestone, Farm Bureau Insurance has you covered for auto, home, and life insurance. For a free quote and great customer service, stop by the Farm Bureau office in Morrison today or call 668-7075. Because at the end of the day, we treat people right. And that's why we're Tennessee's insurance company.
92.1 The Ticket.
Come on in and see how good it feels.
You'll always
is be treated right when you arrive at Ed Rogers Chevrolet Buick with the new Chevrolet and Buick vehicles, plus a great selection of quality used vehicles. At Ed Rogers Chevrolet Buick, there's also an outstanding service department, proud to be family-owned for over 50 years.
So come on in and see how good it feels.
Get that great feeling of saving money today at Ed Rogers Chevrolet Buick in Sparta and edrogerschevy.net.
Hey everyone, this is Cody Boston, the pulpit minister for the Central Church of Christ located in downtown McMinnville, Tennessee. We want to invite you to come and join us this Sunday for worship. We have Bible classes for all ages that begin at 9:30 a.m. and worship follows at 10:30. We would love to have you come and worship with us and go to class with us and have a chance to get to know you. You can find us on Facebook and on YouTube. Just look up the Central Church of Christ in McMinnville, Tennessee, and you can find out all the events that we have going on. We hope that you have a great day. Take care and God bless.
92.1 The Ticket.
Citizens Tri-County Bank is proud to support Warren County Pioneer Athletics. These sports build character, integrity, and goodwill, all traits vital to success. It's the same mentality in which we do banking. Since 1972, Citizens Tri-County Bank has been serving customers across this region with the highest customer service standards. Stop by any of our four locations in McMinnville and Warren County and experience a different kind of banking atmosphere. Citizens Tri-County Bank, the only community bank you'll ever need. Equal housing lender, member FDIC.
Why won't this work?
Don't lose your cool. Call Black's Heating and Air for a preseason check-in service on your central air conditioning system. It can increase the life and dependability of your unit while reducing the chances of a very sticky situation.
Unbelievable!
Get that air conditioner checked now.
This is Benny Black.
And this is Seth Black with Black's Heating Air.
Call today, 931-668-0785.
Benny's slogan at Black's Heating and Air is, once you've had Black, you won't go back.
Mention this ad and you can get a discount.
92.1 The Ticket.
Back at Nunley Stadium at halftime, 49-0 Gallatin. The Gallatin band performing here at halftime. Doing a really good job playing some B-52 music there.
Yeah. There you go.
Now playing old music from the Turtles from the 60s. I remember that. You don't.
Before my time.
Well, let's take a look at some of the scoring, all from Gallatin in the first half. There's 10 minutes to play in the opening quarter. It was Stroop connecting with Barksdale on a 14-yard pass play. Kick by Kelly made it 7-0. 6:19 to go in the first quarter. Brinkley with an 8-yard touchdown run. Kick by Kelly made it 14-0. 2:57 to go in the first quarter. Williams, a 28-yard touchdown run. Kicked by Kelly, made it 21-0. That was the end of the first quarter score. 6:33 to go in the second quarter. Stroop connects with Dulcey on a 28-yard pass play. Kicked by Kelly, makes it 28-0. Stroop connects with McMurray on a 28-yard pass play with 4:25 to go in the second period. Kelly's kick makes it 35-0. 4:11 to go. Fumble recovery in the end zone by Gallatin. The kick by Kelly makes it 42-0. And then with 2 minutes to go, Brinkley with a 4-yard touchdown run. Kick by Kelly makes it 49-0. Orange County with 4 first downs in the first half. Greenway with 7 first downs. Orange County losing 1 interception. And the Greenway losing 1 fumble. Actually, Warren County lost a couple of fumbles as well. Penalty yardage, 2 for Warren County for 20 yards. 4 for Gallatin for 30 yards.
You really don't want to hear my numbers.
Probably not.
Man, I'll tell you what. Warren County's got minus 29 yards. That is about 30.
to the Warren County Pioneer Prime Pan.
House Speaker Cameron Sexton. Over the last decade with new leadership, our economy has thrived. It is simple. Focus on the people, not the government. So we cut your taxes by $2.1 billion, reduce red tape, and make government work for you. And as a result, we have seen unprecedented growth and over 492,000 new jobs. I'm Cameron Sexton, people before politics.
there bragging on him some. So
that's great. And filling in for Jeff Lee next week will be a Warren County Pioneer basketball coach, Danny Fish.
Tell him if he gets us a win, I'll let him come back the next week. He may enjoy this.
Yeah, I think he's looking forward to it.
It's a lot of fun.
Yeah. So looking forward to that. And again, it's at Cookeville, first to three straight on the road for Warren County. We've got Cookeville and then Green Hill, who we've never played, and then Tullahoma. Then back for a senior night and homecoming against Wilson Central, and we'll finish things off at Father Ryan in Nashville.
Looking forward to that trip. Said no one.
So, but hard to believe after tonight, we're halfway done with this season.
Yeah, it just seems to fly by. This year has flown by.
It has. 49-0 Gallatin. Second half, well, probably go pretty quick. So we're going to take a break and come back for the second half kickoff in just a moment.
Foster and Foster.
Tired of waiting on that IT company to finally get to your issue? Sick of having someone or yourself having to wear the IT hat? Well, in the words of Uncle Joey, cut it out. Benlam & Connect's managed IT team is here. From security awareness training, firewall installation and management, antivirus and malware protection updates, to disaster recovery, cloud backup, and much more, you can let the BLC managed IT crew carry the load for a single project or every day. So cut it out and replace it with BLC's managed IT. For more, go to BenlamConnect.com. Some exclusions may apply.
92.1 The Ticket.
Home is where the heart is. It's also where your valuables, your vehicle, and your family is. So it's safe to say, if it's at home, you probably want to protect it. Luckily, no matter where your home is or the things that matter the most, Farm Bureau Insurance is never far away. Your local agent, Kevin Roten, is just up the road. Located at 6282 Manchester Highway, that's the light at Bridgestone, Farm Bureau Insurance has you covered for auto, home, and life insurance. For a free quote and great customer service, stop by the Farm Bureau office in Morrison today. Call 668-7075, because at the end of the day, we treat people right, and that's why we're Tennessee's insurance company.
Why did you open up Newt's Barbecue in Rock Island?
I wanted to share some old-time recipes that came from my family and other people around here that's been in business a long time.
And what makes your barbecue so good?
Well, it goes back about 30 years ago with Pope Taylor taught me to barbecue. Been barbecuing ever since.
What are your hours of operation?
Right now, we're running every day except Tuesday, 11 to 7. If you're running late and call me, I'll wait on you. So that I'm not a restaurant. I'm a kitchen away from my home.
92.1 The Ticket.
Warren County will get the ball first to begin the second half. Kelly sets to kick off. Robledo back deep along with McKinley. This is a squibber. It'll go right through the end zone.
Even his miss hits are late. Yeah.
Another touchback for the Pioneers, who will get the ball first and 10 at the 20. Clock didn't start. No, I did. 20-yard line. Don't know at what point the mercy rule goes into effect. We would think the entire second half.
30 points, second half.
Warren County with three receivers near side. Follows under center, sends a man in motion. Hands to Robledo, looking for running room. He crawls forward to about the 24.
Missed our block on the edge there. We had numbers out there. It's at the edge.
Gallatin leads it 49-0 as we start the second half. Swallows under center. Sends a man in motion. Swallows looking to throw. Pass is going to be incomplete.
Oh, had him open too.
Had a man open. That was intended for Jax Patterson.
Incomplete. Third and seven.
Now they've got the clock running. Normally it will be stopped after an incompletion. It'll be third down six at the Pioneer 24. Two receivers left. Warren County moving from your left to your right. Swallow steps up, tries to run, and he'll be taken down for a loss at the 21.
That hole closed quick.
It did. So it'll be fourth and long, fourth and nine. And Warren County will get their punt unit in. Duggan standing back at his own eight. Snap is there. The punt is away by Duggan. It's a good one. And it's going to take a good Warren County roll.
Wow.
Gallatin just getting away from it. It's going to be downed at the 18-yard line in Gallatin territory. Great punt by Duggan. .33 to go in the third period. Clock continuing to run. We're in the continuous clock under the mercy rule. Gallatin leads it 49-0. Stroop still in the game at quarterback.
He's been in the play probably one series and then.
Yeah. Brinkley at running back. Two receivers right, one left. Give goes to Brinkley, straight up the middle. Nothing there. Nicely played by the Pioneer defense. It will be second down. And 10. You wouldn't expect Stroop to throw the ball at this point in the game.
You wouldn't think, but.
You never know.
The 60-yard punt just announced on there. What a
good punt. Handoff goes to Brinkley. And again, Warren County playing it well. Limits him to only 1 yard. And it's going to be third down and nine. Well, he might have to throw here.
Pioneer defense showing a little bit of pride here on this possession.
They are. McKinley making that tackle. Clock down to 8 minutes here in the third period. Gallatin leads 49-0. They come with two receivers right, one left. Gallatin moving from your right to your left. Back to throw, Stroop. Pass is going to be got a man wide open at the 40. Defender falls down in Warren County territory, 30, 20, 10, and into the end zone.
Yeah, just we lost him in coverage over on the side.
another Gallatin touchdown. Jeremiah Williams on the receiving end. He was wide open, made the catch. The defender fell down and left him wide open. Stroop to Williams. Now Kelly in. Now this may be the different kicker. That kick is up and good. That is Austin Oschbreimer, the freshman kicker for Gallatin. Puts it through.
Good leg.
And with 7:36 to go in the third period, Gallatin leads it 56-0. Back in a moment. Period. Gallatin leads it 56-0. Back in a moment.
Are you thinking about buying your first home, or maybe downsizing or upgrading from your current home? Is it just time for a change? Paul Holder Realty and Auction Company can answer all your questions about buying or selling. Paul Holder Realty and Auction Company is a family-owned business that's been serving Middle Tennessee since 1955. Stop by their office today at 108 East Main Street in McMinnville, or give them a call at 931-473-7321 to get the area's hardest working real estate company working for you. Firm license number 33.
Need a fun place for the whole family? Look no further. Check out Detention at the Elementary is your family entertainment center fun for the whole family. You can grab a bite on the all-you-can-eat salad bar or check out their menu and hit the arcade, eat, play, repeat. It's that simple. Whether it's a birthday party, special events, or a night out, there's fun to be had for all ages. Give them a call today at 931-773-7529.
92.1 The Ticket.
Out to the 10, 15. Cuts it to the near side. 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50. And out of bounds in Gallatin territory at the 48-yard line.
Good return.
That is Isaiah. Now check that. That is going to be Adrian Harris with a return. So a nice return by Harris at the Gallatin 48. First kickoff returned by Warren County tonight. Warren County to the line, got a new quarterback in. That is another Robledo. He's going to keep it, and he'll go down for no gain. That is Christopher Robledo. He's a freshman. 5'6", 125.
Might as well get in a little work here this afternoon.
Yeah. Not real big, but he's a good athlete. We've seen him as a receiver a time or two. Pioneers come with two receivers left side. Robledo in the shotgun. Takes the snap, drops back to throw. Pass is going to be complete at the 45 and down to the 42. Throws it to Isaiah Robledo. It'll be third down. Third and four from the Gallatin 42. Nice pass by.
It really was. Well thrown on that out route. One of the hardest balls to throw.
Two receivers, right side. Robledo in the shotgun. Robledo takes the snap, drops back to throw. Pass is going to be complete at the 35-yard line. He'll be driven back, but that is a First National Bank first down. Jax Patterson making the catch. Fifth first down of the game for the Pioneers.
Looks like Gallatin's got their second string defensive backs in. for the second string linemen. Yeah, still got their linebackers in.
Gallatin leading 56-0. 4:31 to go, third quarter. Two receivers left. Back to throw, Robledo. Looking now, having to run, loses the football. He'll be fallen on by Pioneer. Back at the 42.
Had to go to run, got it stripped out of his hand there.
Creed Adams falling on the loose ball. But a big loss on the play. And second down, about 18. .348 to go, third quarter, 56-0, Gallatin. Been total domination tonight by the Green Wave. Two receivers right. Robledo under center. Sends a man in motion, Robledo rolling left. Throws.
And
incomplete. Just under threw it. That'll bring up fourth down.
Well, the student section from Gallatin brought their own sound system over
there.
Did,
yeah. Well, the marker says third down. So apparently third and 18, if that's correct. Yep, I guess so. He sure changed it in a hurry. Play clock down to 12. Warren County lines it up. Two receivers right. Robledo takes the snap, drops back to throw, getting pressure. And down he goes, back at the Warren County 45-yard line.
He may be hurt.
Player still down for Warren County. That is Xavier Simmons, shaken up. Maybe cramping. Injury timeout. We'll be right back. Injury timeout. We'll be right back.
Hello, Rhonda Walker here with Citizens Tri-County Bank. If you have mortgage needs and are looking for someone who will work hard for you, please stop by and see me. We offer conventional as well as all types of government loans, VA, FHA, and rural development. And if your work hours make it hard to visit us in person, we have a mobile app we can share with you so you can apply anytime, even nights or on the weekend. Just give us a call and we'll promptly make our mobile app available to you. We are a community bank that cares about personal relationships and we want to get to know you, whether we do it in person or online. Member FDIC and Equal Opportunity Lender.
Mudbum's Family Sports Grill is now offering a meat and three for only $10, Monday through Friday from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. Monday is meatloaf, Tuesday ham, Wednesday fried pork chops, Thursday turkey and dressing, and Friday catfish. Mudbum's Family Sports Grill is located in the Northgate Shopping Center. Give them a call at 931-507-2867 or just come to the place to be just winging it.
92.1, The Ticket.
By Gallatin, but there was a flag on the play. So the officials are discussing it. I don't know what the flag could have been. Nobody hit him. And he didn't attempt to run it. So the officials continue to discuss it. And the clock continues to run. And we may run out of time here in the third quarter while the officials are talking. Down to 44 seconds. The officials continue to have a conversation. They may tell them to put more, and they're going to pick up the flag. I kind of thought they might.
Well, they just proceeded to run a minute and a half off the clock, didn't they?
Yeah. Well, that might be to Warren County's advantage.
And they're going to let it run on out.
Yeah, Gallatin's going to let it run out. They're not going to run play here as the clock down to 11 seconds. That's going to be the end of the third quarter. At the end of three, your score, Gallatin 56, Warren County nothing. Back in a moment.
Gallatin 56, Warren County nothing. Back in a moment.
Hi, this is Alex Nathan, Champion Chevrolet GMC of McMinnville. I want to personally invite you to our sizzling summer clearance sale. We've got the country's hottest small SUVs like the Chevy Trax and Trailblazer, and they start about $22,000. Or you can save up to $8,000 on the Silverado or Sierra. I'm Alex Nathan.
And I'm Amanda Nathan.
We put the family in family-owned business.
And our family will save your family a lot of money.
Champion of McMinnville, 1600 Sparta Street or championchevy.com.
No more sorting meds, waiting in line, or chasing down refills. Graves Family Pharmacy is now offering Pack My Meds, an easy way to take your daily medication. Here's how it works. We work directly with your doctors to save you time and frustration. We monitor and sort all of your prescriptions and supplements by date and time. Organize them into pouch packages so you can pick them up with no wait. No more requests for refills and no more sorting. The best part? We offer this service at no extra cost to our patients. We do it all for you at Graves Family Pharmacy. Call us at 473-6418. Our goal with Pack My Meds is to simplify your life.
92.1, The Ticket.
Got a new quarterback in for Gallatin. We'll get his name for you in a moment. Hands off to the running back, and he is going to be just flattened. New running back in the game is Micah Bell, 6'2", 190 junior. New quarterback is Riley Ridings. Ridings taking the snap, handing off to Bell, trying to get outside, nowhere to go.
They have lost yards on that one.
Yeah. Warren County playing it well. Got some young kids out there. They're glad to be out there. This will be third down and 13 from the 11. Two receivers right, one left. Ridings in the shotgun. Sends the man in motion. Ridings gives to the motion man, trying the far side. Nicely played by Warren County. Ball may have come out. Seems to be a scramble. And looks like Gallatin must have fallen on it.
Yeah, we hadn't got very many of those.
Warren County says they've got it. And Warren County came out with it. Pioneers have recovered.
Good job there.
Connor Williams coming out with a loose football. Second fumble of the night for Gallatin. And Warren County will have the ball at the Gallatin 12. So a chance for Warren County to get it in the end zone.
And get that goose egg off the scoreboard.
9:52 to go in the game. 56-0 Gallatin. Christopher Robledo, the freshman, now at quarterback. Warren County lines it up. Wide outs are two receivers near side, one to the far side. Robledo in the shotgun. Robledo taking the snap, throwing over the middle.
Ooh, that was a dangerous throw.
And it is, was it caught?
No, it hit the ground.
It threw it into traffic.
Oh, he threw it in a group of people, didn't he?
Yeah, he did. Incomplete, it's going to be second down and 10. .8:48 to go in the game, 56-0. Gallatin. Second and 10 from the Gallatin 12. Wide out to the near side. Robledo to center. Sends a man in motion. Robledo inside handoff goes to Isaiah Robledo, and he will take it to the end zone. Touchdown, Pioneer.
Good job. At least we didn't get shut out tonight.
We did not.
Talk about winning, coming out winning the second half. You know, mentally we won the second half there. We scored more than they have. So we kept the fight going.
8:19 to go in the game. Warren County on the scoreboard. Isaiah Robledo taking the handoff from Christopher Robledo. Now Duggan in to attempt the extra point. Warren County late getting a player on. Snap is down. The kick is good. Timeout on the field. 8:19 to go. Warren County finally on the board. It is Gallatin 56, Warren County 7. Back in a moment. Warren County 7. Back in a moment.
Nothing says how much someone means to you quite like the gift of fine jewelry. And no one knows that better than Diamond Jewelry Company. For over 60 years, Diamond Jewelry has been there for that nervous engagement, the wedding vows, the anniversaries, the moms, daughters, and those special I love yous. David Stinson is a fourth generation jeweler committed to making those events the very best. Come see their showroom of one-of-a-kind jewelry in downtown McMinnville or follow them on Facebook and Instagram. Diamond Jewelry Company. They sell memories.
During these times we live in where new vehicle inventory is extremely low, here at Ed Rogers Valley Ford, ordering a new vehicle is a breeze. Ed Rogers Valley Ford is continuing to provide the best customer service from our fully trained new vehicle sales staff. Also, one of the largest pre-owned vehicle selections in the Upper Cumberland area with over 100 pre-owned vehicles to choose from. And don't forget, Ed Rogers Valley Ford will buy your car even if you don't buy theirs. Ed Rogers Valley Ford, Highway 111 across from the Walmart in Sparta, or visit us at edrogersvalleyford.com.
92.1, The Ticket.
And it's now 56-7. Here's the kickoff by Duggan. Well, he called for a fair catch.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
He's going to run it. Trying the far side, no flag on the play as the returner is run out of bounds. He called for a fair catch back there. I think he was just calling for it, but he did wave his hand as if to make a fair catch, but I see no flag on the play. And so they'll give Gallatin the 35-yard line. Or the 33. Riding's the quarterback. Two receivers right. Riding's will hand it off to Bell. Nice run as he gets it out to the 40.
One of those sweet plays, they're very good at being able to put a foot in the ground and head north. See an open spot and go.
Clock running, 7:12 to go in the game. There's a flag on the play against Gallatin. Holding is a call against Gallatin. Aiden Luber making the tackle for Warren County. That'll put the ball back at the 24. Two receivers right, one left. Ridings taking the snap, going to pass it out to the near side, incomplete. Intended for Jesse McNair. Clock continues to run. 6:22 left to play. It'll be second and 19. Gallatin with the ball at the Gallatin 24. Two receivers right, one left. Ridings taking the snap, drops back to throw. Pass over the middle is incomplete.
Tipped at the line of scrimmage. So.
Well, They'll make it third and long for Gallatin. Ball at the war at the Gallatin 24. .536 to go in the game. Two receivers right for Gallatin, one left. Ridings back to throw. Getting chased. Looking for a receiver. And throws it. Overthrows his intended receiver.
Receiver quit running.
Yeah, that's Alec Brown, the intended receiver. This could be fourth and long, and looks like Gallatin will have to punt.
First time tonight.
First time tonight. That is going to be Max Kelly into punt. And we saw him punt in pregame. He is a good punter. Gage Harris back deep to receive the punt. And he might need to back up.
Yeah, I was just thinking that.
The punt is away. And this is going to drive him back. It'll roll inside the 20. Harris needs to get away from it. And it'll be down by Gallatin at the 16.
Yeah, we towed him to back up.
4:16 to go in the game. Gallatin leading 56-7. Warren County will have it at their own 16. It would be nice if they could stick it in the end zone one more time.
Pretty good drive last time. Yeah. Let's see what we can do.
Christopher Robledo back in at quarterback, the young freshman. Robledo under center. Wide out to the near side. Sends a man in motion. Robledo pitches to the motion man. That is Isaiah Robledo. Gets to the corner and works it out to the 25. And that'll be enough for a First National Bank first down. Actually, that was Harris, not Robledo. Robledo under center. First and 10 Pioneers. Pitches to Isaiah Robledo, looking for running room. Gets to the corner. Still on his feet. And now bobbled in after a gain of a couple.
He juked that one defender out of his shoes, didn't he?
2:33 to go in the game. Second down, 7. From the Warren County 29. Christopher Robledo getting the play from the sideline. Clock running as we get down to the 2-minute mark. Two receivers left, one right. Actually, two receivers left, two right. Robledo in the shotgun, taking the snap. Rolling left, looking. Now throwing downfield. It is caught by Isaiah Robledo. And he'll go down at the 32-yard line. Robledo lost his footing right after he caught it, or he might still be running.
We got a Gallatin player down.
Gallatin player shaken up. Clock stopped with a minute 33 to go.
Warren County's had about three or four explosive plays for downfield. And that's where our yardage has come from.
Yeah, you like seeing it from these youngsters.
Look good.
Isaiah Robledo is only a sophomore. Christopher Robledo is a freshman.
Could be a quarterback controversy next year.
Hey, could be. Well, the injured player for Gallatin is going off the field. That is Adam Winkleman.
Number 31.
Timeout on the field. We'll keep it right here. Next Friday night, we're on the road to Cookeville to take on the Cavaliers. It is a region game. We'll have the broadcast starting at 6:45 here on 92.1 The Ticket. Hope you'll be listening. First and 10, Pioneers at the Gallatin, 32. Robledo under center. Robledo being chased, and he'll be sacked back at the 41. Oh, he had no chance on that one.
Now, most of the time when your offensive lineman is chasing the one doing the sack, you know you're in trouble.
Bryce Stady making the play for Gallatin. It'll be second down and 17. We're under a minute to play, 47 seconds to go, clock running. Robledo under center. Receiver to the right side. Robledo sending a man in motion, being chased again. This time getting out of trouble, having to run. Throws it away, and there's not a receiver in the area. Just threw it out of bounds. I think the official's not going to bother with a flag. This game's almost over. Well, yeah, it is over.
It is over.
Normally, I think you'd have had grounding there, but why bother with it? That's the game. Gallatin wins it. Final score, Gallatin 56, Warren County 7. We'll take a break, come back, wrap it up from Nunley Stadium in just a moment.
Oh, look at the smoke.
Yeah.
And the electricity my co-op provides is more essential to it than ever before. It allows me to shop online while I'm watching TV and keeps my mobile phone charged so I can return the 10 missed calls from my mother. I depend on the electricity from my co-op to power my life and keep me connected every single day. Learn more about the power of your co-op membership at togetherwesave.com.
Call Caney Fork Electric at 473-3116.
Coffee Bank and Trust can help you find the right financing option for any purchase with fixed rates and terms up to 7 years on new cars and 10 years on boats and RVs. We are your local banking solution. Coffee Bank and Trust, a division of Coffee County Bank. Subject to credit approval, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
WAKI McMinnville, W221ED, McMinnville. Sports Radio, 92.1 The Ticket, a PEG broadcasting station.
Seven total domination by the Green Wave. Warren County able to get on the board very late in the game. And we saw some good things out of Warren County's new backup quarterback, Christopher Robledo.
Yeah, played hard, man. That little escape artist to a degree, but some of those big linemen he couldn't, but throws a good ball too, so we're very proud to see him get some action.
Yeah, Swallows really, he pretty much took a beating out there. He really tonight. Did. So why not let Robledo get some snaps, some reps out there? It's only going to help him in the future. Well, looking at the scoring tonight, it's been just about all Green Wave. Stroop connects with Barksdale with 10 minutes to go in the first quarter. 14-yard pass, kicked by Kelly, makes it 7-0. 6:19 to go in the first period. Brinkley with an 8-yard touchdown run. Kick by Kelly, makes it 14-0. 2:56 to go in the opening quarter. Williams on a 28-yard run. Kick by Kelly, makes it 21-0. That was the score at the end of the first quarter. 6:33 to go in the half. Stroop connects with Goolsby on a 28-yard pass. Kick by Kelly, makes it 28-0. 4:25 to go in the second quarter. Stroop connects with McMurray on a 28-yard pass. Kick by Kelly, makes it 35-0. 4:11 to go. Warren County fumbles into the end zone, recovered by Gallatin. Kelly's kick makes it 42-0. 2 minutes to go in the first half. Brinkley with another 4-yard touchdown run. Kick by Kelly makes it 49-0. That was the score at halftime. Gallatin would get on the board one more time in the third quarter. Stroop connecting with Williams on a pass play. Kick by Ashbrammer makes it 56-0. Warren County would finally get on the board with 8:19 to go in the fourth period. Isaiah Robledo with a 12-yard touchdown run. Kick by Duggan makes it 56-7. Warren County with 7 first downs. 7-4 the Green Wave. Warren County losing a fumble and an interception. The Green Wave losing 2 fumbles. Warren County with 2 penalties for 20 yards. Gallatin at 5 penalties for 40 yards.
The Gallatin Green Wave tonight had a total of 406 yards of offense. And that's most of that was in the first half we talked about. Warren County had minus 23 yards rushing total and 128 yards passing. Passing game looked good at times. You know, we were unfortunately only 8 of 24, so the 8 that we did connect on. But those were the big plays. You look at the eight pass completion was really our highlight reel tonight. Other than that, it was all Gallatin. Their big running back rushed for let me see what I got him for. It was right at 100 yards. So he done his damage, but really the Green Wave did all their damage on the passing. They were everybody throw the ball deep, run good patterns, and unbelievable catches they made over our defenders. So
yeah,
they're just a top-notch program.
Well, Warren County played a lot of young men tonight. A lot of youngsters getting in on the action, and that's, as we said, that's going to help them in the future. You know, Warren County fans, again, going to have to be patient with this team.
We've said that the last couple of years.
Yes,
so
we have.
Hopefully one of these days they're going to put it together.
Yeah. But you never know what's going to happen. These guys getting some valuable game experience.
That's the only way you get
that's
better
right.
is actually play
that's
the game
right.
and do it.
That's right. All right, Gallatin wins it 56-7 over the Pioneers. Next three games going to be on the road, so we're going to be road warriors for a while. Next Friday night, we're at Cookeville to take on the Cookeville Cavaliers. Game time, 7 o'clock. We'll have the broadcast right here at 92.1, The Ticket. Hope you'll be listening with us. No TV next week, as far as we know, unless Cookeville has some streaming.
They're not as talented as we are.
We do
they're
have
not as sophisticated.
We
as
do a, have some good TV guys.
We got tip our hats to those guys. They do
absolutely.
A great job. Tommy's doing a great job back there. And again, a culinary arts for feeding us well. We love being home.
That way, we are very fortunate.
Yes,
loving what we do. That's going to do it from Nunley Stadium. We thank you so much for listening and watching with us tonight. We'll see you next week at Cookeville. For Jeff Lee, I'm Shane Walker. Good night, everybody.
Pulpit minister for the Central Church of Christ located in downtown McMinnville, Tennessee. We want to invite you to come and join us this Sunday for worship. We have Bible classes for all ages that begin at 9:30 a.m. and worship follows at 10:30. We would love to have you come and worship with us and go to class with us and have a chance to get to know you. You can find us on Facebook and on YouTube. Just look up the Central